So we are here at the headquarters of Meerlanden in Rijzenhout, a small town very close to Schiphol, the Dutch airport. Meerlanden is a public waste management company and we work for 9 cities, and those cities are our owners, they're our stakeholders, and yet they're also our clients, our end users through our customers. We are here now in front of a gas station, and that our citizens, they got rid of their waste, their organic waste, that we basically use that waste to make green gas, and that we basically have our garbage trucks drive on that green gas to get the new bio-waste again to make even more green gas. Pretty neat system. Now I would like to go to a nice visual that's very close to our composting and fermentation plant that will show in more detail how we basically make the green gas. So follow me. Biowaste basically consists of vegetables, fruits, and yard waste. I think on an annual basis we collect like 55,000 ton biowaste. Now we bring that to this facility, and the first thing we do is basically get rid of the stuff that's not supposed to be part of biowaste. For example, pieces of glass or plastic. After that, we basically bring the biowaste into the digester or fermentation plant, and we add fats and water to the biowaste. Now, an interesting detail is that the fat is all reused fat. We typically get those fats from restaurants, for example. So we add fat, we add water, and then we use an oven that's, we burn that on wood to heat up to 55 degrees, if I'm correct. So after that heat is established, we let it sit for 2 weeks in an enclosed silo to do its work. And after that, we have biogas. After we created or produced the biogas that we then turned into green gas, we continue with the more traditional process of producing compost. So what happens next? After those 2 weeks that we had that brown mud of biowaste into the digester, we get the residue out of it, and we pump that into another part of our plant, the composting plant. There we add fresh biowaste and wood chips. The reason why we're doing that otherwise it would be too moist to create compost. So after we have been adding the wood chips and the fresh biowaste, we bring that to another part of the composting plant where we let it sit for 4 weeks and let just nature do its work. After those 4 weeks, we basically have to compost. So the really nice thing about our composting and fermentation plant is that we also create more products, more resources out of our biowaste. Not only the green gas and the compost, but also, for example, warmth. And we use a pipeline to transport that warmth to some greeneries close by, and they use the warmth to heat up their own place. Another resource that we use is the water. The water that basically is part of the composting process. It's like condensation water or process water. We use that water to maintain the roads. We have a third additional product that we call, carbon dioxide. That could be used by greenhouses to help their plants grow even better. Where now I think only 10% of the carbon dioxide that we produce is used. In the future, we want to make sure that all the amount of carbon dioxide will be used in a sound way. We definitely created a closed loop here. The biowaste that we collect at the front doors of our citizens are transformed into compost and into green gas.